السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين، أما بعد. إن شاء الله تعالى we will continue with the benefits of استغفار. And in the last session we talked about two main benefits of استغفار. The first one is the purification of the heart, and the second one is the promise from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive our sins. One of the benefits of istighfar is what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in his hadith. And I want you, my dear brothers and sisters, to listen to this hadith carefully and to see how the person will be proud of his sahifa, his record on the day of judgment, because of the istighfar that is in his sahifa, because of seeking Allah's forgiveness, which is recorded in his record before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم طوبى لمن وجد في صحيفته استغفارا يوم القيامة. طوبى لمن وجد في صحيفته استغفارا يوم القيامة. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, good end, big, great reward, happiness, pleasure, waiting for the one who will have istighfar in his sahifa on the day of judgment, in his record. The person who has istighfar in his record will have a good end, will have a great reward, will have happiness and pleasure from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وفي حديث آخر قال الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم من أحب أن تسره صحيفته فليكثر فيها من الاستغفار. In another hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whoever wants to be happy about his record on the day of judgment, if you want to be pleased with your record on the day of judgment, he said, من أحب أن تسره صحيفته, whoever loves to be pleased and to be happy about his record on the day of judgment, let him have more istighfar in it. Let him have more and more istighfar in his sahifa on the day of judgment. He will be the happiest person ever. So my dear brothers and sisters, remember this great benefit of istighfar, that the person who has more istighfar in his sahifa will be proud of his actions and deeds on the day of judgment and will be so happy about his record and about his صحيفة. لنعلم أيضا أن الاستغفار من أهم وسائل نيل رحمة الله تعالى في الدنيا والآخرة. إذا أراد العبد أن يحقق أو أن ينال رحمة الله عز وجل في هذه الدنيا وفي الآخرة فليكثر من الاستغفار. وذلك في قصة سيدنا صالح عليه الصلاة والسلام، يقول الله عز وجل يا قوم لما تستعجلون بالسيئة قبل الحسنة لولا تستغفرون الله لعلكم ترحمون. My dear brothers and sisters, this is one of the great benefits of istighfar, is that istighfar is one of the main ways to achieve Allah's mercy in this world and in the hereafter. If the servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to get and to gain Allah's mercy in this world and in the hereafter, let him have more istighfar. We see this in the Quran, in the story of Prophet Salih alayhi salatu wassalam, the one who was the prophet who was sent to the people of Thamud, and they disobeyed and they did not follow him. And then Prophet Salih alayhi salatu wasalam, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, قال يا قوم لما تستعجلون بالسيئة قبل الحسنة. O my people, why are you hastening the evil deed before the good deed. Why you are anxiously waiting to do something bad, whereas you are supposed to do something good. You're supposed to be competing and vying with each other towards the goodness, not towards the evil. He said to them, لَوْلَا تَسْتَغْفِرُونَ اللَّهَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. Why do you not ask Allah for forgiveness so you will achieve Allah's mercy? Here we see in this ayah, the condition of achieving Allah's mercy is to have istighfar. لَوْلَا تَسْتَغْفِرُونَ اللَّهَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. Why do you not ask Allah for forgiveness so that you will achieve Allah's mercy? Now we see, my dear brothers and sisters, that istighfar is one of the means to achieve Allah's mercy in this world and in the hereafter. وَمِن فَوَائِدِ الْإِسْتِغْفَارِ وَهِيَ فَائِدَةٌ عَظِيمَةٌ. There is a great, great benefit of istighfar. It is actually the main goal of every Muslim is to achieve Jannah, is to enter Jannah and to be saved from the fire. Subhanallah, one of the main benefits of istighfar is to make the Muslim achieve this goal of entering Jannah and being saved from the fire. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا فَعَلُوا فَاحِشَةً أَوْ ظَلَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ ذَكَرُوا اللَّهَ فَاسْتَغْفَرُوا لِذُنُوبِهِمْ وَمَنْ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَلَمْ يُصِرُّوا عَلَى مَا فَعَلُوا وَهُمْ يَعْلَمُونَ أُولَئِكَ جَزَاؤُهُمْ مَغْفِرَةٌ مِنْ رَبِّهِمْ وجنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار خالدين فيها ونعم أجر العاملين. We see, my dear brothers and sisters, in this ayah, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes it very clear that the person who makes a mistake or commits a sin or wrongs himself and then remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and then asks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness, because Allah is the only one who forgives the sins. And that person does not insist on the wrongdoing and the mistakes and the sins that he is committing and he is doing. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the following ayah, then the reward of those people who are always asking Allah for forgiveness, they will have this forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. مَغْفِرَةٌ مِّن رَبِّهِمْ. Not only that, but they will have Jannat, they will have paradise, heavens, underneath which rivers flow. They will reside therein forever. What a good reward and a great compensation for those righteous ones who are working hard in order to get their sins erased and to get them forgiven by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَنِعْمَ أَجْرُ الْعَامِلِينَ. There are many other ayat in the Quran that also confirm the meaning of this ayah, which indicates that istighfar is a way of entering Jannah. And that's why we have to abide by istighfar all the time. My dear brothers and sisters, if we want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make things easy for us, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in his hadith, من لزم الاستغفار جعل الله له من كل ضيق مخرجا ومن كل هم فرجا ورزقه من حيث لا يحتسب. What a great benefit of istighfar. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whoever abides by istighfar, من لزم الاستغفار, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make a way out for him from every distress, every problem, every hardship, every difficulty, every sadness. That person will find a way out. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help him to get out of that. من لزم الاستغفار. And look at the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, lazima al-istighfar, which means that this person is not making istighfar only one time, two times, three times, or restricting himself to a certain number of times of istighfar. No, this person makes istighfar his habit. He abides by istighfar. He commits himself to istighfar. Lazima al-istighfar. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him these things. Number one, جعل الله له من كل ضيق مخرجا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make a way out for him from every distress that he is facing in this life. ومن كل هم فرجا. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ease the sadness, the hardship, the difficulty that he is facing. And on the top of that, ورزقه من حيث لا يحتسب. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will provide for him from whatever he does not count. You will see blessings in your sustenance, in your provision, in your income, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is blessing every single aspect of the life of the person who is abiding by istighfar. So, today, inshallah ta'ala, we talked about three main benefits of istighfar. We talked about three main benefits of istighfar, and we need to, inshallah, reflect on them and to make sure that we are getting these benefits. One of the benefits of istighfar that we talked about today is that istighfar will make the one or the person who is abiding by it, will make that person very pleased, very happy on the Day of Judgment, and he will be very proud of his sahifa and his record before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Istighfar is also a way to obtain Allah's mercy in this world and in the hereafter. And istighfar is a way to achieve the main goal of every Muslim, and that is Jannah, paradise, entering Jannah and being saved from the fire. And last but not the least, actually four benefits today about istighfar, for istighfar. The last one, or number four, is that istighfar will make a way out from every difficulty, from every hardship, will ease the sadness, the grief of the person, will grant him happiness in this life, and on the top of that will be a way to bless the rizq, the sustenance and the provision of this person. So remember, my dear brothers and sisters, that we talked so far about six benefits of istighfar. Keep them in mind and abide by istighfar. Allahumma inna nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. O Allah, we ask you for your forgiveness and we repent to you. O Allah, make it easy for us. O Allah, grant us mercy in this life and in the hereafter. O Allah, ease our hardship and our difficulty. O Allah, make a way out for us from every difficulty, every problem, every issue that we face in this life. Make it easy for us and make us from those who listen to the words and follow the best of them. Those are the ones that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided, and those are the ones that are of sound understanding. اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى ومن العمل ما ترضى برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا واستر عيوبنا واشرح صدورنا وبلغنا مما يرضيك آمالنا. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا كلها دقها وجلها أولها وآخرها علانيتها وسرها ما علمنا منها وما لم نعلم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك، أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت، أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. والعصر، إن الإنسان لفي خسر، إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. جزاكم الله خيرا، والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.